Hey guys, Ernie here, and welcome to the Paleo Hiker MD channel. Over the years, I've reviewed quite a few wood stoves, and I've been frequently asked to review the Sierra Zip wood stove. Well, I finally got one, so let's check out this pretty awesome little stove that has an integrated electric fan to make it burn a little hotter. Thanks for watching, guys. Now, one of my favorite fire starting tools over the years has been the pocket bellows. You've seen me use it on countless videos. It allows you to add a little bit of oxygen just where you want it inside of a fire to get it going again. So it makes sense that adding a small fan to the base of your fire or the base of your stove would really make a difference with performance. Let's find out. Let's check out the stove first though. So here's our kit. It's got a lot going on. I'm gonna pull it out here. Comes in this little nylon bag, pretty nondescript nylon bag. This is what they call the stove with the complete upgrade kit. Comes inside of this little Ollie Camp pot kit. And I actually have one of these already. This is my second one. I've owned one. This was probably the first cook kit that I bought way back when. It's been a long time. Dimensions are 4 by 5 inches. We're gonna take it out. The top, as you can see, is like a little fry pan. Here's the pot part. One nice part about it is that it locks into place. You can lock this. It's really nice. And then you just unlock it. Like I said, I have another one that I've used a lot more. I have several videos where I used it. Here's the stove. We'll pull out the fan portion first. Inside, we'll pull this part out as well. So this is, as I said, the stove canister. It says right here, made in the USA. It's just a burn chamber, and on the inside it's got these holes throughout the bottom so that when you put the fan unit underneath, I'll show you how it goes on, the air just flies right in here. This is the fan unit, okay? We'll get these legs out. These kind of spring in a little bit, and you just pop it right in there, and you've got your stove, just like that. And you can see the fan underneath there. This is the battery adapter. It plugs right in here. Okay, and has a low and a high setting. Put this for you guys, you can see it. I'm just gonna take this off so you can see quickly how it works. It's not rocket science here. Low and high. And it's off. So pretty cool. As you use it, these will kind of bend in. So you just pull them out every once in a while so that they attach nice and tight, just like that. And you've got your stove. Now this is a wind guard, which is also pretty neat. So you can obviously put a pot right on top of these supports. It does also come with this little cross stand. Pops on like that. And you can put your top right there. You get the cross stand along with this, and it's pretty secure. You can put your pot right on there, no big deal. We're gonna use it without either today. We're just going to put the pot right on top of here. So let's load this thing up, start a fire, and boil some water. Now the company recommends that you get the fire going first, and then after it starts to develop a little bit, that's when you actually kick the fan on. Now there's a low setting and a high setting. I will note that when I got this stove in, the little battery pack that you connect to the stove was faulty. I'd have to turn it just the right way to get the fan to get going. So I contacted the Wiseman Company, which is the retailer for this stove, and they got a new one out to me in the mail the next day. I think I got it about 4 or 5 days later, so they were super responsive, apologetic, and took care of it, no problem. Now, of course, we could use regular wood for this stove, but I wanted to change it up a little bit and try using wood pellets. I've been experimenting with wood pellets recently. We've had a lot of terrible weather recently in Louisiana. All kinds of stuff that has really disrupted our power. It's disrupted the way we cook. We've had multiple episodes where we've been out of electricity for days and days. And that really got me thinking about my preps and starting to shore up my preps. Wood pellets are readily available. They're super dry. They're easy to store. So I've been trying them out and thinking about adding them to my preps. And I've got a couple buckets on the way. Yes, I live on 10 acres and I'm surrounded by woods. So there's no Well, right now I'm in Arkansas, I'm not at home. Nonetheless, where I live in Louisiana, I'm surrounded by woods and I have plenty of fuel, but I really like the idea of having something readily available that I can just run right in, grab it, start a fire, don't have to worry about any prep at all, and that's why I'm adding these wood pellets. You can basically never have enough alternatives when it comes to fuel. I'm also checking out a new fire starter today from one of our sponsors, Pro Camtech. They've put out what they call the Ultimate Fire Tender. I've used it a couple times just messing around with it, but this is the first time I'll use it starting a fire. So let's get a fire going, boil a little water, and see how this stove works. That was pretty quick. That boiled that roughly 2 cups of water in 2 minutes, 25 seconds. Pretty freaking impressive. Now this is the fire going by itself, just to give you guys an idea. No fan assist. Now it is going very well. Got tons of wood pellets in here. I'm gonna turn it on to low. Pretty nice pickup in flame. Turn off again. You see it drop down quite a bit. Go back to low. I'll turn it off. Now I'm gonna kick it up to high so you guys can see what it looks like going full steam. Significant difference. Significant difference. Let me show you guys what it looks like on the inside. So what do you guys think about this stove? It's pretty cool. It's not ultralight, obviously, and it's not designed to be, but it's still relatively lightweight for what you're getting. It's well made, it's very well thought out the way it's all put together, and it really creates a tremendously hot fire when you crank that fan on. This is the perfect stove for an emergency kit. If you combine it with the pellets, it gives you a safe and easy way to get a fire going anytime, anywhere. One AA battery will power the fan for about 6 hours, and you can also buy an adapter that will allow you to hook it up to a larger battery. And I'm sure if you figured it out, you could probably find a way to hook it up to a USB battery bank or something if you wanted longer term usage. Overall, I think it's a great off-the-grid solution. Combine it with a solar panel and some way to recharge some AA batteries, and you can keep this thing going for a long time. What do you guys think about this stove? I think it's pretty cool. There's several other stoves on the market. In fact, I have another one from BRS that has an integrated fan. It's a very different design, so we'll be checking that out down the road as well. I think the stove is pretty awesome. I also like the fact that it's an American company. I always love supporting American companies and any kind of a smaller company that we can help these days with the pandemic and how difficult the economy is. I think it's great to do so. So if you're interested in a stove like this, check down below. I'll leave a link in the description. Not sure if you guys are aware, but I have an entire playlist on stoves, all kinds of stoves, wood stoves, gas stoves, solid fuel stoves, alcohol stoves, any kind of stove you're looking for. I have over 100 videos on them. Make sure you check that down below and up here in the cards as well. Do me a favor, guys. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. Really helps spread things across YouTube. If you're not subscribed, hit the subscription button. And if you want to make sure you're notified as soon as I release new videos, hit the notification bell and you will be the first to know. I really appreciate everyone checking out the channel. I've really had a lot of growth lately and I really, really enjoy making these videos. As always, guys, I appreciate you checking out the Paleo Hiker MD channel. Stay tuned for more videos soon.